raise your hand and speak.
I have a great relationship with this college. Reason you already know, that my mother was an alumni of this college, and I have a relationship of a generation with this college. So when I was told that you have to go and give a lecture here, I felt very happy, because coming to this college and talking to all of you is something that I always wanted to do. And I believe that in this session, in this mentoring session, all of you will be benefited from what all experience that I have gained in the service as a student, what my experiences have been, and especially as a woman. Though there are males also who are sitting here, and I believe they might also like to take home some points that I speak of. But I'm primarily going to focus on the women who are sitting here, who are getting their education in different colleges of this cluster university. So my topic today is mentoring and a structured approach to career. 51% of the PhDs are women in our country. 49% of them are doing MSCs, and they have become postgraduates. What's happening then? Can anybody say? What is the reason that that girls, even after getting educated, are not coming into the workforce? Survey in 2020 says that it is only 20% women who join the labor force. And rural women are leaving jobs much more, much faster. Biggest weakness is lack of self-confidence. They don't believe that they can achieve something. In fact, the biggest weakness, I may tell you, is not to come in leadership positions. We see women, they are coming in so many different fields, doctors, engineers, architects, pilots, but still at the top level, women are not entering into leadership positions. Why? And this is not just in our developing country, but even in developed countries.
Answers to questions which pop up at crossroads of our design of performance acceleration system. The what, why, when and how constantly tire our underlying beliefs and assumptions.
A bunch of roses for a woman who was a rose in the college.